How to create a Raglan short sleeve t-shirt fashion flat sketch in Adobe Illustrator. Let's start with finding a similar Raglan sleeve t-shirt on web, which we are going to sketch. After deciding on a garment, save it on your computer. Open a blank document, A4 size. Select the artboard tool from the tools menu and select the landscape mode. And now file and select place. Select the t-shirt you have recently saved on your computer and click the place button. As you can see, the t-shirt is now placed on the artboard. Resize the t-shirt so that it will fit on the artboard. Select the pen tool. Press the Command and R to activate the rulers. Now we will place a guide in the middle of the front neck drop to shorten the sketching process and making the fashion flat sketch look more symmetrical. Drag the mouse cursor over the edge of the vertical ruler on the left hand side of the screen. Press the left mouse button and drag it in the middle of the front neck drop. Double click on the current layer. From the layer options menu, select the dim image 50% and click the OK button. If you're having trouble seeing the t-shirt, you can try a higher percentage level like 75 or 80% or vice versa. Now lock the layer and create a new layer on top of the current layer. Let's start sketching the t-shirt with the help of the pen tool. The first step is to create the outline of the garment. To do this, we will start with the front view of the t-shirt and then we will create the back view afterwards. Select the stroke from the appearance tab and assign the black color. We don't need any fill color at the moment. That's why we leave it blank. Now let's start drawing the left side of the outline. Once you're done, select the outline, open the stroke panel and select the round cap and round join. Select and copy the outline sketch of the t-shirt. Press on the O letter on your keyboard and drag the mouse cursor on the guide and press your left mouse button. This will place an anchor on the guide and with the help of this anchor we will copy and duplicate the outline of right side of the t-shirt. Press and hold Shift and Alt buttons together. Click on your left mouse button and drag the outline to the right side of the guide, 90 degrees. Now the outline of the t-shirt is completed, but we have to connect the end points of the both sides in order to make it look like a shape. Grab the direct selection tool from the tools menu and select both end points on the front collar and press on the connect selected end points button. Replicate the same process for the lower end points, which are located in the center of the hem. We have a shape object now and we can fill it with any color we want to. It's time to sketch the front collar now. Zoom in to the center of the front collar and start drawing with the pen tool. We will only sketch the left hand side of the collar and duplicate it later. Select both of the lines and press on the O letter on your keyboard and drag an anchor on the guide. Press and hold Shift and Alt buttons together while you're dragging the front collar lines to the right hand side. Merge the end points. Select everything. And from the Pathfinder menu, select Divide. Now we have a group object. right-click on the t-shirt outline and ungroup the object. Let's draw the raglan sleeve armholes now. Select the armhole lines and the front body together and divide and ungroup the object. Now we move to draw the back collar drop. We will use the same process for it. The front view of the t-shirt fashion flat is ready. And now we are going to create the back view of the t-shirt. In order to create the back view of the raglan sleeve t-shirt flat sketch, we just simply copy and paste the front view of the t-shirt and place it next to it. Select the back view of the t-shirt. From the Pathfinder menu, select Unite. Now what we have on the artboard is definitely not something that we're looking for. You see these dots and separate lines on the color line. These are the result of overlapping lines of the color. You might end up in similar situations when you try to combine individual shapes together. When you right-click on the back view of the t-shirt, you will notice the shape is recognized as a compound path instead of a group object. Just click on the Release Compound Path tab. It's just like the ungroup option, but now we will be able to select the individual paths and lines. But it would take very long time to select each line one by one and delete it. Instead, we select the outline of the t-shirt and press Command and X button together to cut. Now we see all the unwanted pieces on the artboard. We just select them all and press the Delete button. Go to Edit and use the Paste in Place option. This will paste the outline of the back view in its place. Place a vertical guide in the center of the back collar. Start drawing the backdrop color line. Replicate the process just like we did for the front view. Now let's add the armholes as well. It is time to add the stitching details on the sleeves and hem. But we need to create the cover stitch brush first. There are lots of different stitching types that are used for different garments for fashion flat sketches, but most commonly used are cover stitch, overlock, and flat lock stitches. Once you get to understand how to create a stitch brush for Illustrator, you can create your own stitch brushes for different garments in Teck Packs. Start with creating a line. Duplicate the line and place it below the first one. We created a cover stitch sample as it is seen from the face of the fabric. Now, draw a rectangle shape to determine the gaps between each stitch. This will form the smallest repeating pattern of the cover stitch. Right-click on the rectangle shape and select Arrange and set to back. And set the stroke to none. By doing this, we create an invisible space between the stitches. Select all of them and drag them into the brushes panel. Rename as Cover Stitching Brush. And change the colorization into tints. This will allow us to change the color of the stitching if we need to. You can now delete the cover stitch pattern. We don't need it anymore. Now let's draw straight lines on the sleeve openings and hem. Select all three lines on the front view and select the cover stitching brush from the brushes panel. As you can clearly see, the stitching seems quite large. We need to resize the stitching. To do this, double-click on the cover stitching brush in the brushes panel and set the scale to somewhere between 15% and 20%. And click on the Apply to Strokes button. Let's do the same for the back view. Now we can add some color. And we can change the colors of the cover stitching in order to get the contrast color look.